man. This year Halloween fell on a weekend. Me and Ghetto Boy the trick or treating. Robbing little kids for bags. Zillin' Omen got behind our rags.
Man, we losing them left and right. A hip hop legend. You guys just saw my main man, Bushwick Bill, from the Ghetto Boys. He's one third of them. He passed away last night. I didn't even know that he was sick. And we're going to talk about what he died from, his hip hop legacy, and what it meant to me when I was that young. But first, on this channel, we put on our plus seven glasses of rest, letting them rest in peace, sexy as hell, because I'm working on skilling my craft, bringing you a more informed YouTube experience, something better to look at. Please subscribe to this channel, turn on my notifications so when I drop videos you get them. Also, go check out the Life Game Financial channel. I'm letting you guys know how I made it in real estate, how I got to where I'm at, and giving you financial tips to help you guys stack in the black. Bushwick Bill, better known as his government name, Richard Stephen Shaw, just died yesterday, June 9th, of pancreatic cancer. And it was a little bit of a debate because a lot of people was trying to say he wasn't dead. And then it was confirmed. And here's the Wikipedia page. Anytime you need to confirm something, go check out the Wikipedia page. But if you didn't know about his pancreatic cancer, take a quick look at this interview he did, letting people know probably about a month ago.
Like, well, we see a mass on your pancreas and we can't understand because it's not alcohol, it's not sugar, it's not diabetes, it's not, they went through all kinds of stuff. And then finally by February 8th, they said it was stage 4 pancreatitis cancer. And I'm like, stage 4 is like, I've been getting tested and they said it was a mass, but it was benign. And I'm like, does benign mean it could be cancer? And there's like, it's just a mass with no purpose. So it was just crazy to find out that it doesn't, pancreatic cancer is undetected until it's in the 4th or 5th stage. I've been keeping it to myself, but I'm getting ready to tell Scarface and Willie D, and I've only told close family members, you know what I mean? But that's about it. But I figure keeping it to myself is not really helping nobody. And it's not like I'm afraid of dying, because if anyone knows anything about me from Ever So Clear, you know, I died and came back already in June 19th, 1991. So I know what it's like on the other side, so that's not what really it's about. It's about life and loving life and being there for family and not just starting a dream or getting married or getting your first house and then finding out you got pancreatic cancer. You can't even live out the rest of your dream. You know, I just want people to be aware so that way when they set dreams and goals, they're healthy enough to fulfill and live. And the reason why I'm doing 3 albums right now, because I noticed when most celebrities pass, they really don't have nothing set up for their children and everything's in disarray. So I figure old music will sell, yes, but if I have new music for them and I have a book and I have a documentary and I have any other endeavors that I get into now, at least they'll have residual income from those things instead of just knowing that I'm their dad and my old records are selling, that publishing belonged to somebody else. And it's like, I'd rather know for sure that I did my part.
So that was him letting people know. At first he was going to keep it a secret, but then he wanted everyone to know so that he could take this fight head on, deal with it, and leave a legacy for his kids. And I admire him for that. I grew up listening to Ghetto Boys. Some of the first hip hop I ever heard was these guys. It was him, Willie D and the crew. And I can just remember, you know, you would see these guys and they were larger than life. You know, they gave you a little bit of inspiration to get through your day. And I'm just wishing his family well and wishing all his people well. Willie D has a YouTube channel. Go check him out. I'm wishing him well. Everybody in this situation has got to be hurt because this guy was a real good dude. They was thinking about doing a TV show, getting back together, and Bushwick Bill never did get involved with it. But I want to know what you guys think. What was his impact and the impact that the Ghetto Boys had on your hip-hop era growing up? Back then, around the early 90s, I was like 10, 11, and 12. And I know there was days when their music got me through practices, it got me through homework, it kept me upbeat and kept me going forward. So I just want to send a big shout out to the family. I wish you guys well. I hope you get through your healing pretty fast. But let me guys know about your early beginnings with hip hop and how the Ghetto Boys impacted your life. And we'll rest in peace, Bushwick Bill. And thank you for all the contributions you gave to hip hop. That's gonna do it for this video. Don't forget to like my video. Please comment, subscribe, go get yourself a life, game. Send a shout out to the family, man. Let them know that you care. Let them know that you're sad for their loss. Brother was trying to leave a good legacy. He had a lot of important things going on, and we'll wish them well. And until that next Sex is Hell video, I'll see you.